Hey, it's JP from the Junkies. Football season is finally back, and BetQL is ready to help you win more consistently this year. BetQL is an absolute game changer. If you're looking to find trends to help you win, make smarter bets on spreads, totals, player props, and more, BetQL has already helped over 300,000 people with powerful analytics and community insights. Don't fumble away your cash this football season. Visit BetQL.com for their free daily analysis today. That's BetQL.com.
Stand by for an urgent bulletin.
This is the Bob and Jeff Show, starring Bob Lutz.
I can't wait till you get to this stage of your life where I am, and you're able to really examine things.
It's going to be legend. Wait for it. And I hope you're not lactose intolerant, because the second half of that word is dairy. Legendary.
And Jason Duda. For today, anyway.
Hey, enjoy it while you can. I've seen how this turns out.
Yeah? Tell me about it, girl. 97.5
and 1240 KFH.
I heartily endorse this event or product.
All right, we are back. This is the second hour of the Bob and Jeff Show, KFH Radio. Jason Duda in for Jeff today. He'll also be here. Will Jason. Tomorrow we'll talk with Dylan Schmidt, head football coach at Andale. We'll talk with Joanna Chadwick from Vibe Magazine. Some high school football talk on the show tomorrow. Shocker Volleyball at home tonight in their own tournament against KU. That's interesting. So we'll be following that as the Shocker Volleyball team, which had a good weekend last weekend. We'll see what they do against a very good Kansas team. We're getting more and more into the swing of things here.
Well, this is starting to get to the busy time, right?
Yeah.
I mean, the summers is, you got baseball, and that's kind of it. Now we're getting, obviously, we have football tonight. NFL starts tonight. College started last weekend. Like you said, football,
high school up and running.
Football, everything else. College starting to get going. I mean, now it's
high school tennis.
Everything. Everything's going on.
Which you're involved in with your daughter.
Which I am involved
in. And
then
a lot of soccer.
A lot of soccer going on.
All over the place. Yep. Dallas.
Yep. Drive Kansas down to
City.
Texas. And Kansas
lots
City.
Of different places.
Yeah, all over the world. All over the world. That's kind of the way it works. You know, it is what it is. It's all good. It's all
no
good.
No question. It's all good. I'm just bringing it up. Don't snap at me.
Oh, no. I know you're bringing it up. I know you're bringing it up for great reasons, too. Which is fantastic.
Is my friend Jackson listening to this? Nah, he's still in school, right?
Yeah, he's still in school. So, yeah, he's not listening right now.
We don't have to worry about that.
No.
Him taking offense.
To you again?
Something I may say.
True. Which is nice.
Now, if we get a little cooler weather, which it looks like we're going to get here shortly. It looks like Monday we're going to have a high of around 74.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
Oh.
So if we get a game coming up on some fairly reasonable weather day,
yeah,
let me know.
Okay.
And I'll come up with some reason not to make it.
Absolutely you will. You've been so good with that for the last 5 years.
That's terrible of
me. It's crazy. It's crazy. He stopped asking. After 3.5 years, he quit asking.
Well, he's 26 now.
Yeah. Yeah. It's just kind of a club game now.
Do you still play indoor?
No.
No?
No. They played indoor last winter. I don't know if they'll do it this year, winter or not. It'll be different because he'll be high school.
He'll be ninth grade next year.
Yeah, so I don't know how all that works. I know they can't play club because half of his team right now.
Well, he could play club, but he couldn't play high school.
Right, so you got to do one. So he's playing. He'll play. Hopefully, play high school. So. Have the team right now, half of his team is playing at Mays or Mays South, because that's where most of the kids are going to school. And so then next year, I don't know. We'll see what happens. It's too confusing for me.
Well, I mean, your kids are growing up. It won't be long until you bid adieu
to
Avery.
Well, it's, yeah.
And then Jackson will be right on the heels of that.
That is true.
So my granddaughter visited Kent University.
Did she? I know that Jeff was talking about that, about going up there. I wonder how, did you talk to her? Did she like it?
It didn't hit with her.
Didn't stick?
No, that's a long way from home.
Yeah.
Not that she couldn't handle it, because she obviously could, but I don't know that that's going to be the destination. Now, they were going to look at a place in New York as well, but I don't know if that's still the plan or not.
It's got to be interesting, and it will be interesting to try to figure out where they want to go, what they want to do, how you help them with it. I'll have to reach out to some people that have done it because it'll be brand new to me, you know, with my scholastic ability.
Academia is not something, no offense when I say this, academia is not something you've really delved into very much.
Bob, I'll have you know that I was the Scholastic Player of the Year.
No question.
For the Saskatoon Blades 1 year.
Well, outstanding. That was when you were in, were you in school?
Yeah, I was 17. Did you have? So I was like grade 12. And I'll still remember Lauren Mulliken walking into the dressing room mad as hell. And Lauren was a good coach. He ended up coaching for the Chicago Blackhawks, their head coach for 3 years.
Wow.
And he walks in and says, "You idiots, I got to name Duda as our Scholastic Player of the Year. On the ice, no pucks."
So that's how bad it was.
Yeah, we didn't have a smart team.
Not a lot of brains.
Didn't have a smart team, but we did have seven of those guys ended up playing in the NHL.
Well,
so
that's all congratulations.
I guess it wasn't too bad for most of them.
They made it to their destination.
That they did.
Well, good for them.
Happy days.
Yeah, nothing. Absolutely nothing wrong with that.
Nope. Not a thing.
So we got week two college football. We had an interesting week one as it pertains to the Big 12, no question about it. Baylor knocked off by Texas State. Nobody could have foreseen that.
No.
So they play. They've got Utah coming to Waco. I don't think that'll go well for the Bears. Now, the thing about college football from week to week, you never know.
You have no idea. You have no clue what's going on. It's not easy to figure out college sports in general most of the time. But how they lost that game, I didn't watch it.
I didn't watch it either.
And
so
there's a reason why I didn't watch it. I didn't think there was any need to watch it.
And, of course, you have Texas Tech, which is expected to be kind of a team to contend. They lost at Wyoming in week one. Texas Tech has an interesting game, to say the least, against Oregon coming up this Saturday in Lubbock. And we really don't know now what to think of Texas Tech. Texas Tech and Baylor stumbled out of the gate.
Yes, that would be one way to put it, no question.
And, of course, TCU did as well. And we'll see how they recover. They've got a Patsy and Nichols State this week. That won't tell us much. But there's some interesting games, not the least of which is Illinois and Kansas coming up in Lawrence tomorrow night. I look forward to watching that ball game tomorrow night.
It should be a good game. It should be a close game, I would think.
Wait a minute. Tomorrow night. Oh, man.
Is it tomorrow? They play Friday night. That's right. Yeah. They do play Friday.
Their second straight week playing Friday. But I've got tickets to see Three Dog Night at the Cotillion.
Uh-oh.
I went a couple years ago to see Three Dog Night at the Cotillion. Had just a great time. These guys are older than dirt in Three Dog Night, a lot of them. But, well, you know, Danny Hutton, the only real
how
original.
How old is that? Because
they're older than me.
Okay, that's where I was going to go with this.
And great, again, wonderful that they're still doing it, right?
Of course,
I mean,
it is.
It's remarkable.
Yeah.
That the guys in Three Dog Night are still out there. But it's, man, they had a couple guys sitting on the stools last time they played. Danny Hutton is, believe it or not, 80 years old.
Come on.
He's 80.
80?
He's 80, and he'll be the front man for Three Dog Night tomorrow night at the Cotillion Ballroom.
At 80?
Ballroom. Do they still call it the ballroom?
I have no idea.
I don't know. Have you ever been to a show at the Cotillion? It's a great venue for
I have been.
Who'd you see?
It was a comedian. It was a while ago. Was it a comedian? Who was that?
I don't know if it would have been a comedian.
No, it wasn't a comedian. I can't remember. I've been there once, but it was years ago.
Well, I've been there I've probably been there 8 to 10 times. It's not like I'm out there for every show they have.
Right.
But every time I go, I enjoy it because it's just a unique venue for a concert. And the last time Three Dog Night was there, it was packed. They played all the hits. You reminisce, you go back in time. And that's what us older people do. We go back in time and we enjoy it. And I'll be damned if I'm going to be talked out of it. I don't care what you young people think. If I want to go back in time, I'll go back in time.
Well, there's a lot more go back in time than there is look forwarding in time, right?
Why are you saying that?
Well, I just...
That's morbid.
I'm kind of sticking up for Weston here. You called him a veteran. You said he went to school in 67. You said a lot of things about the man. And I've got to know him a little bit on this show, and I didn't like it.
Did you not hear him say you're going to your 70-year high school reunion?
Absolutely, and you deserved it, and a few more. So I'm gonna fill in for him. And
Weston gives it out as good as he gets it.
That I can tell.
And I've known him long enough to where we can have that kind of a give and take.
Well, and you're supposed to.
That's what friends do.
That's
and it's what Weston and I do.
Okay, so you consider yourselves friends? Or does he consider him a friend?
Yeah, there's no question.
And he considers you an acquaintance.
We've known each other, like I said, since he was a sophomore in high school. So that would have been in the neighborhood of 1977. That's a long time ago.
That is a long time ago.
That's 46 years, my friend.
Yeah, that's a while. Yeah, well, then you can definitely, I'm okay with that.
There you go.
I'm okay with that.
I appreciate that.
Oh, you're welcome.
I try not to step on anybody's toes, but, you know, we do what we have to do. So an interesting week in college football. We went through what the NFL looks like.
The afternoon games are much better. We didn't kind of dive into them, but the afternoon games are.
What's the number one thing you're looking forward to in the National Football League coming up this week? Not necessarily a game, but maybe a player that you're intrigued by.
Well, obviously, you're intrigued by Aaron Rodgers to see what's going to happen.
Yeah,
I'm not a big fan of Aaron Rodgers, but let's be honest. If there's a storyline going into the season, that's it. Guy has been in Green Bay his whole entire career. He's 38 or 39 years old. He's going to the Jets, who are basically trying to sell out to win a championship in the next couple years. You got Breece Hall, obviously, who we pay attention to, should be coming back. So the Jets, oh my God, I'm talking about the Jets again. The Jets are probably the interesting story of the year, and I'm curious to see.
They are going in, but they could fall off a cliff.
No question, but going in, if you're asking me right now,
why do I want them to fall off a cliff?
Because you don't like Aaron Rodgers.
No, I don't.
So that's why
I love Breece Hall.
That's why you want him to fall off a cliff.
But is my disdain for Aaron Rodgers amount to more than my appreciation for Breece Hall?
That only
Breece Hall's from my city.
Exactly.
He's from right here.
Exactly. And you're the only one that can answer that question. You posed it to yourself. What's the answer? Do you hate
Aaron
Rodgers?
I don't want the Jets to do well, which makes me feel tremendously guilty. Because if I have been consistent with one thing over my professional life, it's for wanting Wichitans who come out of Wichita high schools to do well at the next level. I have consistently wanted that. And so I'm trying to figure out how I can have both. Maybe Breece Hall can have a Pro Bowl year, but the Jets can go 7-10.
Or I don't want to say that because that's not good to say, so I'm not going to.
You don't want anybody to get hurt.
No, exactly.
Were you going there?
I was going there. I was saying if he got injured, didn't play, the Jets played well, Breece has a fantastic year, then different story. But
yeah,
you never want to say
that. Don't
want
to wish an injury on somebody.
On nobody. Even guys I didn't like when you played against them.
You don't want
to. You wanted to knock them out for the game, they could play the next game. That's how it was.
Well, how do you – you can't be that precise. If you knock them out for that game, how do you know they're not going to be out for the following?
Give a cross-check to the teeth. He's got to go get stitches. Can't play that game. But he can play the next night.
A cross-check to the teeth.
That's what guys used to do back in the 90s.
Well, that's just horrible.
Well, that's the way the game was played.
Did you get a cross-check to the teeth?
Oh, well, these aren't all mine, Bob.
Well, that's just an awful situation with hockey.
That was 30 years ago.
Is it still that way?
That's not that way anymore. Well, I don't think so. No, not. Even later on in my career when I was still playing in the between 2000 and 2010, it was it was nowhere near as it was in the 90s.
Well, that's
the 90s was an all-out brawl all the time. I don't know what it was.
Was it enjoyable? I mean, I know you love playing hockey. What are you drawn
sometimes,
to as a kid?
Sometimes it was like, oh, my God, here we go again. No question.
But you're drawn to playing hockey because of the skating, the precision.
Absolutely.
The skill.
But some guys weren't playing hockey that didn't have that, and that was kind of their role. That was kind of the job that they took on. It was different. And you knew the guys on the other team that was their role.
Well, the guys on your team had
that
role.
And so you let those guys handle it.
Who was one of those guys on your team?
Oh, we had lots of guys. But the one guy that always stands out for, I mean, Chris Schultz was one.
Schultze.
Derek Parker had 50 fights in one season.
Well, that's crazy.
50.
What do you call him? What's his nickname?
Well, we just called him Parks.
Oh, that whole nickname thing. Why not something pugilistic? Why not?
Like what?
Fighter or...
This is just
slugger,
Parks.
You know.
No, Parks.
Just Park.
Just Parks or Parksy.
Parks. What a bunch of Neanderthals. I hate to be that blunt, but my God. Just a constant fight.
It was, he fought 50 times. We only played 64 games. And he had 50 fights.
A few times twice in a game.
He went on and he did all that. In Canada, they started that big thing where it was pay-per-view and all these hockey players would go and you basically fought. There were two-minute rounds. Three rounds, 2 minutes. And they fought.
Wow.
It was just like and then he actually went and did some MMA stuff.
Parksy.
And the nicest... sweetest guy away from you would have no idea he was a tough guy.
We ought to try to find him.
Oh, God, I'd love to talk to Parks.
Oh, let's get Parks.
Oh,
look for him tonight.
I will. I know that he's on Facebook because Dio always says every once in a while that Parker was doing this or that and that sort of thing.
Let's get him on the show tomorrow for 5 questions.
If I can find him, I will.
All right. That's your job tonight.
Okay, well, that's not an easy one.
Your job hangs in the balance.
Oh, I'm going to get fired?
Maybe. Oh.
Thank goodness.
Look what happened when I threatened Max. Colby Rogers was on this show immediately. All right, we will take
That's
a break.
So
we're going to make picks. 8 games on the docket, 4 in the college ranks, 4 in the NFL. Max is the early leader out of the chute. 5-3 last week, 20 points. I was 4-4 for 20. Jeff, 4-4, 17 points. And we pick with confidence points, of course. Duda in last place, 3-5, 13 points. We'll see if he can better his situation. Picks next. Stay with us.
This is the Bob and Jeff Show on 97.5 and 1240 KFH.
Rock and roll never forgets. Bob Seger, Rock and Roll Week here on the show. Jeff is joining us from New York City. Jeff, where are you?
We're in the hotel right now, starting to think about getting ready to go to the show and walk down toward Madison Square Garden. We're not far away from MSG, so very excited. Very, very, very,
I thought you were
very,
staying with relatives, but you're staying excited. In a hotel.
We stayed with relatives last night. We're staying in a hotel tonight, so we don't have to get on the train real late at night. We can just walk over to the hotel, fall asleep, head over there in the morning, and then ship on out.
That's actually very smart, Jeffrey.
Thank you. I came up with that all by myself.
Good job, kid.
Thank you.
All right, Max,
are
we playing some FanDuel thing here? Let's get it rolling.
Picks are presented by FanDuel Sportsbook, America's number one sportsbook, and the official sportsbook of KFH Sports Radio.
KFH Sports Radio. Yeah, that's me. That was it. Good job.
That was exciting. We'll never get that 30 seconds back. Here we go. Picks. We've got them for you. We start in the college ranks. University of Texas on the road to play Alabama. This one went to the wire last year, of course. Alabama, a home 7.5-point favorite. I'm going to pick Alabama for 4. I don't know if I'm a believer yet in Texas. Jeff.
I know we're not doing the NFL picks right now, but I loved earlier when you were going through the schedule. It was like 85 Bears versus 88 49ers. No, that's bad. We have Tom Brady and his Patriots against Terry Bradshaw and the Steelers. That's bad. I've got Texas right here for 6.
Did you understand any of that, Duda?
I had no clue what he was doing or where he was.
Are you smoking a little weed?
Yeah, is it legal there?
I'm not sure, but it better be.
What did that mean?
I have no idea. Where were you going with that?
All your games that you read for the apparently bad games in the early part of the schedule on Sunday. No, and some of them were pretty good games, is what I'm saying.
Which one?
Yeah,
one we said that was decent was going to be San Francisco and Pittsburgh. That interest.
Tennessee, New Orleans is kind of interesting. I think
Tennessee, New Orleans. That's not interesting at all.
I think Indianapolis, Jacksonville is kind of interesting. We get to see Anthony Richardson play. There's a lot of good games out there. I like Houston, Baltimore a little bit too. I think it's all good.
Oh my God! All right, Duda, your pick: UT, Alabama. Alabama 7.5-point home favorites.
Yeah, I am not sold on Texas. Yeah, I know this was last year. It was a different story. I got Alabama for 7.
And finally, Max, how do you feel about this one?
Don't trust Alabama, but I'll take Texas for 1. They probably can cover and keep it within a touchdown at 0.5.
Not on the road. It's not a great pick, but you may get it right. Next, Colorado with Deion Sanders, the talk of the college football world. They're at home to face their rival, Nebraska. 3.5-point favorite for the Buffaloes in Boulder. We start with Jeff.
You'll see by my pick, I had no idea really where to go with this one. Seems like it could be one of those letdown games for Colorado. And I just don't know. I'm a believer, Deion, but I got to see some more still. I guess that makes me not a believer. Nebraska for 1.
I think that's a terrible pick. Duda?
Well, really, because this is painful to say, but I agree with Jeff. This could be a game, all the hype, everybody's talking about them all week, but can they keep that high? It's a rivalry game. I got to take the 3.5, but I'm with Jeff on this. Nebraska for 1.
Smart.
Max, this is easy money. What are you going to do?
Nebraska struggled against Minnesota. They're going to Colorado, the thin atmosphere. I'm going to take Deion in Colorado for 4.
When hasn't Deion Sanders met the challenge? This is what this guy lives for. This is what his players live for. They're at home in Boulder. They're playing their first home game. Oh, my God, this is the easiest. Colorado is going to blow these folks off the field. They may sputter at some point, but not in their first game at home. Colorado for 7.
Easy points for you and I, Bob.
They spent all offseason preparing for TCU and squeaked out that one. It's tougher when you only got a week. I like Matt Rhule to have something for him.
You know, strum a guitar. We'll handle the pick. next, Illinois, Kansas. KU at home, a 3.5-point favorite. Here's where it gets very interesting. I can almost hear KU Pat through the phone, through my headset. Jason Duda has to make this pick right out of the gate. What do you think, Duda?
3.5. This should be a good game. Should be close. Pat, I'm sorry. Illinois for 2.
At least you didn't go 8. But you will never learn. Max.
KU Pat instructed me to take KU, keep it within 4-5, 3-5 rather. So I took KU for 3. Thank you, KU Pat.
I am also taking Kansas. Again, I think they're legitimately good. Their quarterback's pretty healthy. I like KU for 3 as well. Jeff.
Illinois, not terrible, but KU does get Jalen Daniels back, as you mentioned. I think that's enough to win this game by more than a field goal. KU for 4.
Even with Pat breathing down your neck, you couldn't come up and pick Kansas.
I just think it's going to be a closer
yourself.
Game. He just didn't want me to go for 8, so I didn't.
Well,
I still think it's going to be a close game. KU win by 3, that's fine with me. I hope KU wins. If I was going to watch the game and cheer for a team, I'm cheering for KU. No question about it.
Next, we have Troy visiting Kansas State on Saturday, an evening kickoff in Manhattan. The Cats a 16.5-point favorite against a program that has had its share of upsets over the years. Max, you started off.
I wish K-State had saved some of the points they scored last week, but I still like them. I'll take K-State for 5.
Max and I are on similar wavelengths. I like K-State for 6. Jeff.
I like K-State for 7. Let's go. Maybe Duda has them for 8. That'd be sweet.
Duda, what do you think?
Duda's got them for 7. Oh, I hate following Jeff. This is a bad week.
Well, you already picked your 7-point game in Alabama.
Oh, I got him for 6. Sorry.
There you go.
That hurt.
There you have it. Now we go to the National Football League, where we will not be picking Tennessee and New Orleans, believe it or not.
We're not picking Cincinnati and Cleveland.
Such an attractive game,
too. Or Baltimore and Houston.
Yeah,
we're not picking those games?
That's not a good game for crying out loud.
Which game?
We are starting out with Miami and the Chargers. That one played in L.A. at SoFi Stadium. I think that's the name. SoFi, whatever it is. I started out. The Chargers a 3.5-point favorite at home. It is hard to know what to make of the Chargers all the time. It's kind of tough to know what Miami's going to be, too. I'm going to pick the Chargers for 1 point. I have no idea. Jeff.
Everybody's talking about this is the year Justin Herbert kind of elevates even farther into that tier one.
Is this a movie deal you're doing?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Max, is he giving us movie titles?
I don't think so.
No. I miss him doing that stuff.
This is just him talking.
Okay, but he always starts everybody's talking about. Go, Jeff. Who you picking?
I'll bring it back at some point. Just today's not the day. Miami, I've got him for 3.
Duda.
Yeah, tough. I'm with you, Bob. I don't know about the Chargers, what they got. Miami, I mean, their offense should be explosive again. I mean, this should be a high-scoring game. This could be one of those games whoever has the ball last wins. So I'm taking the 3.5, so I'll take Miami for 5.
Mark.
That's a lot of points for having as much doubt as you express. Max.
Nah, they're going cross-country. The Chargers are going to be pretty good. They have to. They've been lingering in potential for so long. I'm taking the Chargers for all 8.
Oh, that's crazy talk.
That's nuts.
That's crazy talk.
I don't know what happened to Max.
I can't believe I just heard that.
In the insane society, the sane man must appear insane.
What?
Think about that one.
Is that a movie title?
No, it's from Star Trek. Spock.
Next. An NFC East battle right out of the chute. The Giants at home to face Dallas. Now, Jeff could really do something cool and hang around till Sunday and go to that game.
That'd be smart.
The Giants and Dallas. Dallas, a road favorite. 2.5 points. Jeff.
Man, I couldn't get us to the Bronx for the Yankees game last night when we were already here. What?
Did you try?
Yeah, I put it out there. I wanted to go to all the boroughs. We hit three. It's all good, though. I'm not going to stay until.
Do you understand anything Dallas. Jeff's saying today?
No,
I don't know how. No. I don't know what's confusing. I've got Dallas for five.
Does it sound like Jeff's had a couple?
I'd be proud of him if he did.
He's not on a Philadelphia level yet.
Well, it's too bad we didn't have a Philadelphia game because then we'd know for sure.
Jeff, have you Philadelphia'd?
Not today, but it's just, you know, I'm very excited. And I can't wait. 4.5 hours till the
Apparently
Eagles.
Apparently, excitement causes him to slur his words.
It's hot in New York,
Duda,
Bob.
Your pick.
It's like 90, 95.
Your pick today on the Giants, Dallas, Duda.
Divisional game. These are always tough, these teams. I got the home team here. I think the Giants are going to be a little better. I'm still not sold on Dallas, so I got the Giants for three.
Max, your thoughts.
Yeah, I like the Giants at home. They look strong. They had a good year last year. Daniel Jones got his contract. I'll take the Giants for seven.
Well, I don't think you guys outside of Jeff are on the right track here.
Dallas has beat them 10 straight times.
This is a huge game for Dallas. And to be the contending team so many think they have to be, and that they will be, I think they go – I don't know where this love for the Giants – is coming from. I've got Dallas, and I'm picking them for five.
That'd be 11 straight wins next. Against the Giants. That can't happen.
Max, I know you're in first place, but tone it down a little, would you?
Ooh, geez, you're fired. Tone it down. I mean, what else you got for Max today?
Buffalo visiting New York as well to face the Jets. Is that right? They can't both be at home. Help me out, Jeff.
I don't care. So you tell me.
I think it's at the Jets, isn't it?
Here's now.
I gotta look.
Here's my son. He's so excited about the Eagles that he's blowing all this off. Doesn't care. It's irritating to me.
I called
here. He did call. You got to give him credit for that. It's at the Jets.
Well, the Giants is at home too. How's that working?
Well, they play Monday night.
Sunday and Monday.
Oh, my goodness. There
Buffalo,
it is.
2.5-point favorite. Sense. Duda, you get the first pick.
Look, I'm not sold on the Jets yet. Buffalo's still the better team until I see more this year. So I got to go with Buffalo for four.
Max.
Buffalo's still the team to beat in the East. I don't care how old man Aaron Rodgers won't take them. Buffalo for six.
Okay, I look at scenarios, and I look at storylines, and I look at what I think the story's going to be after this weekend. I think the story is going to be the Jets, unfortunately. I think the story is going to be the Jets winning this game. Not only covering, but winning the game. That's just what I see in my futuristic bubble. I'm picking the Jets in this one. For one, let's see here, 2 points. Jeff.
I'm right there with you. I am not a Josh Allen believer. I think he's kind of the Clyde Drexler of the NFL, just a notch below some of the elite guys. I will take the Jets for two. I'm buying the hype.
There you go. Big even break there. I can't imagine the Jets losing this game. Just can't. And I know that Buffalo's the real deal. It's not so much an indictment on Buffalo as it is that I just don't think the Jets are going to lose this
just
game.
Just all the hype on the Jets. All the talk on the
it's
Jets.
Not even the
Everybody's
hype.
Just
I can't
hearing
imagine.
the Jets.
I think the Jets are going to be a big story in the league this year.
And I think Buffalo goes in and just puts them in their place.
Well, you're wrong.
Well, we'll find out on Tuesday.
Yeah, we will. I lead, by the way. And I've won this thing. I've stopped counting. Detroit visiting the Chiefs.
Well,
that one tonight
to
up at Arrowhead. That one up at Arrowhead this evening. The Chiefs, a 4.5-point favorite. We start with Max.
I need inspiration.
And so this team's going to be built on, we're going to kick you in the teeth. All right.
I like it.
When you punch us back, we're going to smile at you. And when you knock us down, we're going to get up. And on the way up, we're going to bite a kneecap off. All right.
Oh,
and we're
going
to stand up. And then it's going to take two more shots to knock us down. All right. And on the way up, we're going to take your other kneecap. And we're going to get up. And then it's going to take three shots to get us down. And when we do, we're going to take another hunk out of you. Before long, we're going to be the last one standing.
That guy better not lie to me. I get Detroit for two.
Boy, that's a brave pick. I don't think this is nearly enough points. And I'm certainly not going to buy into Detroit until I really see it. This is the biggest stage the Lions have played on. And I can't think of the last time they were on a stage like this. They are not going to come through here. This is what Patrick Mahomes lives for. Kansas City for eight. Jeff.
Yep, I'm right there. This is just not a game that the Chiefs are going to falter in. I'm not a Detroit. I like Detroit as a team, but it's still Jared Goff. They're relying on a rookie running back for some stuff. So, and one really good wide receiver. So I've got KC for eight also.
Too many similarities with Jeff here.
But, yeah. Doesn't feel very good, does it?
I've got three different picks, so I'm okay. Dude, what about you?
You guys couldn't be more wrong.
Crazy. I can't wait to see
Detroit
you fail.
Is loving the fact that they're going into this, and nobody's
no
giving
faith.
Them a chance. We don't know if Kelsey's playing. Their defense is not very good. Their best player is not playing. Kansas City is – will they probably win? Yeah, but this isn't going to be a blowout. This is going to be a little closer than you think. And it wouldn't shock me if Detroit wins this game tonight.
Well, put your money where your mouth is. You're going Detroit for eight?
You bet your... I can't even say it on the air.
That's the dumbest pick.
Bet your... You know what I'm saying on that.
That's the dumbest pick I've ever heard.
Really? Well, you know what? You and I are going to be here tomorrow.
Hey, Jeff, have fun. Yep. Text me the set list. I'm very interested in that for the Eagles, their final tour. I want to know what they're going to play, and they better do some things. They better do some things differently. I'll just say that.
I hope so, but we'll see. You know, all their songs are good, so can't leave disappointed. See ya.
There you go. There's Jeff. It's almost 5 o'clock. The show starts at 7:30 with Steely Dan taking the stage. So he's right there. He's right there, and I can relate to the excitement he's feeling.
Well, that's good. I hope the kid has a good time.
Oh, he's going to have a great time. All right, there you go, our picks. I think there's no question that I will vault even farther ahead after this week. We just got a minute or so left in the show, a couple minutes.
Do you
have any parting thoughts? Some of the worst picks I've ever seen
gonna
you make.
I was just going to say, like, you're going to fall way behind me after this week's over.
We're completely different on all four NFL games. We're different on Nebraska, Colorado, and we're different on Illinois, Kansas. Given my track record here where I've been outstanding in picks,
what?
It doesn't look good for you.
What are you talking about, outstanding in picks? Like, you say that you've won all these, but you keep record. So when you stop adding all our points
Max
up
keeps
the last
the record.
3 or 4 weeks of the season, of course you're going to win.
Max keeps back up.
Well, and Jeff won last year.
I don't recall that.
It's funny how that works.
I'd need Max to verify that.
I think Max would verify that.
Well, the only reason he won is because I kind of dropped out.
Oh, so you
midway
have an excuse.
Through.
Oh, that's probably it.
Well, I mean, I just don't understand how you could pick the Lions for eight tonight. I do understand how you could pick the Chiefs for eight. I don't understand how you could be that confident that Detroit, a team that's never done anything, is going to go into Kansas City and keep that game manageable.
It will be a manageable game. Kansas City will win by 3 or 4. That's the way it's going to finish. KC wins, but it's going to be
a
close game.
Your entire reputation hinges on it.
Well, it's good. There's not,
right,
there's not much to that reputation
you
anyway.
Can walk into this house tomorrow with your chest pumped out. If you're not, you'll slink down the stairs and take the whooping I'm going to give you.
Is that how it's going to go? That's tomorrow's show,
the
start?
You think they fought on the ice I'll knock every tooth.
Oh, I like it. Oh, I like it. This is great. I can't wait.
You'll be calling me Lutzy.
I will call you Lutzies because we did have a Lutz on the team.
Did you really?
Yes.
Tough guy, wasn't
you
he?
You interviewed him.
Really?
You both last names were spelt the
same. Oh, yeah, I kind of remember that.
You did.
I interviewed him over at the Ice Center.
Yeah, defenseman, good player. And he was Lutzy.
Good player.
No, he was a good player, good defenseman.
Well, there you go.
Lutzy.
Are we going to get that fighter on the air tomorrow?
Well, I'll see what I can do.
What's his name?
Promise. Derek Parker.
Well, I hope we get Derek Parker.
I will.
It would be a fun chat.
It would be fun. I'd love it.
And you have access to him through Facebook.
Well, I
your wife does.
I don't. But, yeah, I'll see if I'll ask her to reach out to him tonight.
Outstanding. I'm sure she's listening. She may have already done it. Parksy.
She's at work.
Well, you never know.
But if we can get Parksy on, oh, boy.
We'll let you know. We hope we can make it happen. Thanks to everyone for listening today. Our guest, Weston Schartz, Cape and Mount Carmel football, Colby Rogers, Shocker basketball. We'll be back tomorrow, as will you. We'll see you then.
What do you get from the Morgan Stanley client experience? Listening more than talking, and a personalized plan to guide you through a changing world.
To learn more, visit morganstanley.com/whyus. Investing involves risk. Morgan Stanley Smith Barney, LLC.